In this video, you will learn how to do a pendulum, how to French free, use cheater sticks, pass gear between climbers, how to lower down to the belay in the middle of a pitch, and how to ascend to your high point if you fall. A pendulum is something you do when you are here, but you want to be over here. Clip the rope into your high point and get your belayer to lower you down. Swing across the wall, building up more distance each time. At the pinnacle of your swing, you'll probably need to grab, clip, or hook something. So be ready for this. Once you've made it across, continue climbing up. You'll end up with horrendous rope drag if you clip everything. It's usually better to back clean for a little while, then use long slings to extend gear. Another solution is to use two lead ropes. If you fall, you could do more back up to your high point, but how secure is the piece that held you? If it blows while you're jumoring back up the rope, you'll fall on the spiky teeth of your jumors, which, depending how far you fall, could be bad news. To avoid this, you could ascend the rope with a gree-gree and a prussic. This way, if the top piece fails, your weight will go on the prussic and gree-gree, which is much kinder to the rope. A common alternative is to use one jumor and a gree-gree. Keep your daisy slack so the weight would always go on to the gree-gree. When you get to your high point, clip in and belay the rope back through to your partner. Sometimes you might need to lower down to the belay in the middle of a pitch, for whatever reason. This is easy if you're less than half a rope length up. But it's still possible if you're higher up. Here's how. You will remain on belay throughout this whole setup. Equalize some good pieces of gear and clip the haul rope to it with two screw gates that are opposite and opposed. Tie an alpine butterfly in the lead rope and clip this into the same carabiners, and fasten the gates. Then get on the haul rope with your gree-gree, and untie from the lead rope. If the lower off point blows, you'll fall onto the lower pieces of gear. You are still on belay, remember? It's not ideal to fall in a gree-gree like this, so make sure the lower off point is good. To ascend back to your high point, use the same technique as described earlier in this video. Tie back into the lead rope, remove everything else, and continue up. You don't need to wear your entire rack on every pitch. Some stuff can be passed up later. The belayer ties off their belay device so they can go hands free. Then tie a knot in the haul rope and clip whatever to it so the leader can just pull it up. If you need more rope, a quick solution is to clip the end of the haul rope into the spare lead rope. Alternatively, use a tagline. The leader then passes the rope down while the belayer takes it in. The leader can also pass gear down by just clipping it to the rope and letting it slide. Wiggle the rope so it doesn't slam down at full speed. Sometimes you might want to switch to free climbing in the middle of a pitch. To make this easier, get your free shoes passed up, then pass down any heavy stuff you don't need, and clip a sling into your top piece as your final foot loop. You may also want to French free a section. No rules here, just do whatever to climb up. It's useful to have a Fifi hook on your belay loop so you can rest on gear. A cheater stick can be used to clip a faraway piece of gear. However, having one handy prevents you from progressing at harder aid, and it's also difficult to test faraway gear, so you might just end up falling anyway. Practice these techniques somewhere safe before climbing a big wall. Thanks for watching.